Hi, Kevindblanch. I was going to go get my tripod, find it, try to put this up. This is fresh out off the wire. Holy cow, these lying TEPCO evil motherfuckers. It's out fresh, brand new off the wire. There's China syndrome going on right now. It's been going on the whole time. In December, the IEA confirmed, that the reactor had 10 meters of water on the spent fuel rods and the core, that it was cooled. They just went in, TEPCO admitting themselves, went in with their scope today. Less than 2 feet. Do you know what that means? Less than 2 feet? They said that it is fusion and it is splattering on the wall in there. This is China syndrome. This is the first time in the history of the world this has happened. And you fucking experts can say, oh, this ain't China syndrome. Just like you, you fuckhead Arnie Gunderson and the rest of you fucking phony pricks the day I put up my video and told me I didn't know a hydrogen bloom from a hydrogen bloom. Well, why don't you tell me this isn't China syndrome? This is fucking China syndrome. It is going on right now. It's been going on the whole time. The most evil chemicals that could possibly be released have been released the whole time. No wonder I got fucking leukemia. As Utahns, we are full of it anyway from the open air test. It is accumulating. Is it accumulative? I'll put up more information on this as I gather it. This is brand new. CBS News is reporting it. That 2 feet, less than 2 feet, on top of the cores and the ponds. You know what that means? That means this is fully... We're talking over a year. The IEA just meet, 2 days ago, come up with their conclusion. They're 44 experts, whatever, and their conclusion, quote, our work is done. Wow, these evil, evil fucks. These lying fucks. And I hope Gunderson and all you fucking IEA and all you so-called are come at me again, just like you did the day of March 12th when I put up that video saying this is a full core meltdown. And this, hey, no wonder I have leukemia. It's wonder the whole fucking world doesn't have fucking leukemia. This is China syndrome. It's on. It's on. These lying fuckers, this is going to be a major fucking story. They've been lying the whole time. Like I said in my first video, fucking entomb the motherfucker already. Obama, the United States government, the UN, fuck the fucking treaties. Fuck them. Go in. Send the Navy. This is a worldwide catastrophic fucking nightmare. These Japanese fuckers just continue to lie. The IEA is doing nothing. We have nobody. Go in. Send the United States Air Force. Fuck these Japanese lying motherfuckers. And go in and entomb the fucker now. Entomb it. I'm telling you, these lying fuckers. We're over a year later, and it's still on. I'll post the article. This is China syndrome, the first time in the history of the world. Do you have any idea of the implications? Oh, fuck, I do. Oh, fuck, no wonder I have leukemia. Kevindblanch.
The operator of the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant has released video footage taken inside the containment vessel of one of the damaged reactors. It was the second time since January that the operator has succeeded in getting into the reactor. Tokyo Electric Power Company used an endoscope to check the water level inside the reactor on Monday. The depth of the water had been thought to be about 3 meters, but was actually only about 60 meters, or rather 60 centimeters. The footage shows the endoscope reaching the water's surface after being lowered about 6 meters into the number 2 reactor vessel. Floating matter, thought to be peeled paint and rust, can be seen floating on the surface. The operator says it is not melted nuclear fuel. But the firm could not identify areas of damage in the vessel. The utility also detected extremely high levels of radiation, measuring 72,900 millisieverts per hour. Any human exposed to this amount of radiation would die within 7 minutes. It's the first time since last year's accident that it has been able to directly monitor inside the vessel. The high radiation and low water levels are a setback for efforts to scrap the reactor. The utility says it does not plan to conduct endoscope surveys in the plant's number 1 and 3 reactors because of the continuing high levels of radiation.
What the fuck?
Japanese scientists will launch a project to study the mechanism of the March 11th earthquake. The Japan Agency for Marine Earth Science and Technology, or JAMSTEC, will dispatch a deep-sea drilling vessel on Sunday. Researchers from JAMSTEC and Kyoto University will be on board. They'll examine the seabed 220 kilometers off the Oshika Peninsula in Miyagi Prefecture. The plate in the area moved 50 meters when the quake occurred.
We'd like to study how the plate moved so much and how the tsunami occurred. We want to learn from the lessons for the future.
Researchers will lower the drill 7,000 meters below the surface of the ocean and then dig 1,000 meters into the Japan Trench. They will collect rock samples from the seabed. They'll also gauge the temperature to calculate the energy generated from the sliding plates.
Japan's Prime Minister Yoshihiko Nona has called on world leaders to share the lessons the country learned from last year's accident at the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear power plant. Nona spoke during a working lunch at the Nuclear Security Summit. And he said Japan learned three lessons from the Fukushima accident: the importance of being prepared, respecting the judgment of people at the scene, and that security can be achieved only through constant efforts.
The primary purpose of my participation was to share with the rest of the world the lessons Japan has learned from the nuclear accident. I wanted to highlight Japan's efforts to secure nuclear safety within the country and around the world.
The Prime Minister said these lessons can also be applied to terrorist attacks on nuclear facilities. Nona said Japan was shackled by the myth that nuclear plants are absolutely safe. He stressed that everyone who is responsible for nuclear safety should be aware there is no such thing as absolute safety. And he said the most difficult but most important task for leaders is to pass on the lessons to future generations.
Well, President Obama, Prime Minister Yoshihiko Noda, and a host of other leaders have wrapped up a nuclear security summit. The meeting in Seoul ended with a statement reaffirming the commitment to a number of goals: nuclear disarmament, nonproliferation, and the effort to secure nuclear materials by 2014 are among them. The statement comes from leaders of 53 nations and representatives of international organizations. The document says they'll aim to strengthen nuclear security, reduce the threat of nuclear terrorism, and prevent materials from getting into the hands of terrorists. Thank you.
이제 우리는 핵터를 없는 보다 더 안전하고 평화로운 세상을 만드는데 새로운 이정표를 만들었습니다.
The statement says leaders will aim to announce voluntary actions by 2013 to minimize the use of highly enriched uranium. The substance can be used for nuclear weapons. The document also referred to the Fukushima Daiichi nuclear accident and called for a better preparation for emergencies. Barack Obama has implored North Korean leaders to have the courage to pursue peace. He vowed to increase the pressure on Pyongyang to prevent the spread of nuclear weapons. And he made the same promise for the leaders of Iran. Obama made the remarks to university students in Seoul ahead of a summit on nuclear security. Obama called on North Korean leaders to refrain from provocative acts for the sake of their own prosperity. He urged them to work with the international community.
By now, it should be clear. Your provocations and pursuit of nuclear weapons have not achieved the security you seek. They have undermined it.
On Iran's nuclear program, Obama said time is running out for diplomacy. He urged Iranian leaders to abide by the Nuclear Non-Proliferation Treaty. Obama also prodded Russia. He said he'd seek discussions with Moscow with the aim of reducing not only strategic nuclear warheads, but also tactical weapons and warheads in reserve. Obama said he plans to discuss this with returning Russian President Vladimir Putin when they meet in May. Obama set expectations high in a speech in Prague 3 years ago when he declared it was time to seek a world without nuclear weapons.
Leaders from around the globe are trying to find common ground on an issue that spreads beyond borders. They've started work on their second day of the Nuclear Security Summit in Seoul. Representatives of 53 countries are calling for international cooperation to prevent nuclear materials from falling into the wrong hands. U.S. President Barack Obama and Japanese Prime Minister Yoshihiko Noda are among those taking part in the discussions. South Korean President Lee Myung-bak opened the meeting noting that terrorism has no borders. He said damage from nuclear terrorism will not be limited to one country. The leaders are believed to be looking at the mechanisms for reinforcing how they manage nuclear materials. They want to ensure those substances don't get into the hands of terrorists. They'll also discuss how to prevent attacks on nuclear plants and how best to manage them in light of the Fukushima disaster. They'll release a communique later in the day, and President Yi is expected to speak about what they've accomplished. The summit delegates also addressed North Korea's plan to launch a rocket next month. They hope to convince the country to abandon its plan. NHK World's Ryoji Ito has more from Seoul.
The leaders were turning up the pressure on North Korea on Monday. U.S. President Obama took the strongest stance. He said there will be no reward for provocations. South Korean President Lee Myung-bak has called for more pressure on North Korea. Both countries are urging China and Russia to use their influence to stop the launch. Russia has urged the North Korea to exercise self-restraint. China says it's making similar efforts. But North Korea is likely to press on with the launch. If new leader Kim Jong-un is seen giving to external pressure, he risks losing the support of the military. We should focus instead on how China reacts to the launch. The country opposes any attempt to destabilize the Korean Peninsula. If China continues to send economic and political assistance to its neighbor, the North may be able to weather the storm. The key will be how much countries like Japan, the US, and South Korea can persuade China to back their position.